Hi guys, welcome to Popscope. Them is an anthological horror thriller series just launched on Amazon Prime Video. The story revolves around a black family who comes to live in all-white neighborhood, California. The events that occur in 10 days living there with them will blow your mind. The story will totally keep you hooked up until the end, so let's not waste any time and get straight into the review and ending explained of Them. And before we begin, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to never miss an update from us. The final episode has plenty of weight because everything before it has preempted that everything will come to realization. It does not feel like a series that will have a continuation. The final episode opens up with Betty trapped in the underground room that George had created for her. She sits in a solemn silence before climbing up the ladders. She realizes the hatch at the top is open. Feeling nervous, Betty leaves the underground room, and it's a bright and wonderful day. She runs across the farm to escape, but George snipes her from a distance. That's the end of Betty in this story. George was in love with Betty. Lucky is still in the mental facility. The doctor tells her she will be receiving a gift. Lucky asks if she can use the restroom before going to the ballroom. As she gets up, she injects a nurse in the neck and they collapses. Back at the house, Ruby asks one of her white neighbors to help her father, who was being hanged. The other man flees, but Henry chases after him and shoots him repeatedly. As they reach the middle of the street, other neighbors come out to see the commotion. Ruby shouts after her father, which snaps him out of it. Episode 10 brings a full horror show as a conclusive ending to the series. The Emory family face their demons, their trauma, and the devil itself as the story goes full circle. At home, it's way more hectic. Them, Season 1, Episode 10 begins to snowball and ending. In the distance, police sirens can be heard. Henry tries to return to the house, but the door shuts on him. Ruby can hear her father's muffled voices, but then she hears children singing. Gracie hears the same thing. As Gracie reaches the wardrobe, someone grabs her. The room that Ruby is in transforms into the school bathroom and she sees Doris. Doris tells Ruby that she knows who she wants to be. She tells her she is just like her mother. As Ruby looks in the mirror, she looks like her mother. The devil is playing on their minds intensely. It's taking over. Henry finally enters the house, but it looks different. He can hear audiences laughing and he enters a cinema auditorium. Henry asks Da-Tap Dance Man where his daughters are. The man laughs at him and tells him that he needs to look with his eyes if he wants to see them. Suddenly, he sees himself and his daughters in the audience. This was the day he took his daughters out to the cinemas and left Lucky with Chester. This was the day she was raped and her little boy was killed. The devil is taunting his mind, playing on his guilt and trauma. While escaping the mental facility, Lucky walks through the groups of white people and they heckle her with racist comments. She screams to shut them all up. This felt like a relief and everyone quintet. It felt in this moment that the racism has peaked to a childish point and only a scream could stop the adults who were acting like children. As she enters the house, a row of fine appears in front of the guard. When she enters, she saves Lucky immediately. On the other hand, Ruby is still immersed in the mirror where she looks like her mother. Her head is plunged into a sink as Doris tries to choke her to death. Lucky finds her and she is holding a shard of glass, hurting herself. She tries to calm her daughter down slowly, but Ruby points the shard of glass at her mother. Lucky tells her she would never hurt her. So Ruby drops the shard of glass. But there's still the father to save and he is perhaps the most inflicted person in the house. Henry is still in the cinema auditorium watching the film with Da-Tap Dance Man. The scenes are showing Lucky being raped and his son getting killed. Da-Tap Dance Man asks when white people are going to stop taking stuff from him. He tells him to show who he is. As he becomes increasingly agitated, Lucky Lee puts a hand on him to calm her husband down. Henry tells Lucky that he should have been there, but she tells him he couldn't have known. As Them Season 1 Episode 10 reaches a conclusive end, there's one last thing to do, confront the devil himself. The family gather and plans to leave the house. Lucky tells them all that they will not be running anymore and heads to the basement. As she walks down the stairs, the door closes behind her. She faces the priest and calls him the devil. The priest talks about keeping the community pure and maintaining purpose. He tells her that this shall not end and that she failed the covenant. The priest explains he understands the loss of a child and the hole it leaves. Suddenly, a baby lays in a basket ahead of Lucky and its Chester. She sobs and picks the baby up, who is crying. The priest offers Chester as a gift. She keeps repeating, "I'm right here," but then she faces the priest and tells him that her boy is gone, and that's where their similarity ends. She tells him he can no longer blind her. Lucky has finally faced her grief. She rips the cross off him and drops it and says, "I see you." Suddenly, the priest remembers his church burning to the ground and goes blind. He scrambles on the floor looking for his cross. His convenient has broken and his body sets on fire. The question that struck everyone was, who was Mrs. Vera and Doris, and what was happening with the supernatural forces? Actually, Mrs. Vera, Doris, and the only one got inside Lucky is not anyone else but the priest Epps. He was the one who was doing all of this. In episode 9, History of Epps was shown that how his community burned and how he burned the black couple to death. He stayed with a boy named Miles, who he found when he was coming back from his son's cremation. When everything burned, Miles revealed that he was the only god Epps was worshipping, and that was the supernatural force. One thing that blew my mind was, by thinking that is the place where Epps died earlier and where the family lives same. As in the starting of the episode, it is seen that Betty seems to know something about the house, and probably that's what she knows. The house was also sold in loss, as no one was taking it. So there's a possibility that was the same place events happened and Betty knew about it. One more thing that struck me was, is Miles the villain of the show or Epps? As we saw, Miles told that Epps worships him and he is the god, and whatever Epps is doing is because of Miles. So that means Miles haters black community and Epps was only its mean. It was also shown that Miles was the only person who unlocked the couple so they can escape, but they were caught and burned, while Miles was smiling behind. But this question can only be answered if the second season of the show comes. At the end, the Emory family leave the house and they are faced with the entire white community and two police officers holding their guns at them. The family stand firm with each other. They are finally together, their souls intact. They are a family again. So, hit your reviews in the comment section. And if you love the video, press the like button and subscribe to the channel to stay connected for exciting updates.